Monkeypox, what is it and should you be concerned at this point in time? I'm Marco Perry. Welcome to the Perry Platform. It almost feels like we're witnessing a plague of biblical proportions. Did Moses get reincarnated somewhere and he is unwittingly unleashing a plague, a financial crisis, food shortages, war, and on top of it, another potential plague with monkeypox here. And this is a thing that's trending right now. Everyone's talking about it. People are freaking out. Is it too early to do that? I'll try to answer that near the end. But it is a serious disease, whether or not it's popping up in the right proportions to make you worry. It's something that you should, at the very least, understand. So, monkeypox, what is it? The following information that I'll be sharing is from the CDC. First of all, it's classified as a rare disease. It's been around for some time. It was first identified in the 1970s. So it's not a novel virus, like COVID-19, for example. Now, although I do say that, it's not like there is a cure for monkeypox. Smallpox and the vaccine for that has been thought of as being somewhat compatible, but monkeypox, as it stands, does not have a de facto proven safe treatment. Typically, monkeypox is endemic, and that is to say localized to Africa, but cases in people have occurred worldwide, typically linked to international travel or imported animals. Now, the natural reservoir, that is the host of monkeypox, remains unknown. However, it is thought that African rodents and primates like monkeys may harbor the virus, and that's where the infection is jumping from to humans. So, let's say you're unfortunate enough to attain the monkeypox virus. What do these symptoms look like? Well, typically it begins with a fever, headache, muscle aches, and exhaustion. Now, here you can make the very obvious observation that these are common symptoms, and they could be synonymous with other types of diseases and infections. In fact, even COVID-19 has very similar traits at this point in time. So, just because you wake up one day and you have a headache, or your muscles are aching, it doesn't mean you have monkeypox. There are other things you'll have to observe to really be sure, and you should always consult with a medical professional. It's not good to self-diagnose yourself. Now, the incubation period, that's the time from infection to symptoms beginning to show. With monkeypox, that's usually 7 to 14 days. So, you could be infected. That's to say, you get the virus within you 2 weeks ago, and only now is it starting to show up. But that can even range further. On the lower end of the spectrum, it'll take at least 5 days, and on the higher end, it can take up to 3 weeks. Now, this is where things start to get kind of crazy. Within 1 to 3 days after the appearance of a fever, this is typically when the patient develops a rash, often beginning on the face, then spreading to other parts of your body. You should Google this. Look up what monkeypox looks like in this state, in this advanced form. Lesions appear and they cover your body, and they go through stages, and in the final stage, there are scabs all over you. Now, the illness typically lasts for 2 to 4 weeks, and in Africa, monkeypox has been shown to cause death in as many as 1 in 10 people who contract the disease. Now, that's quite high. There might be other variables at play there. Do I think if this thing became a pandemic that Canada would have a similar death rate? I'm not so sure, but we also have things going against us. Maybe it could be higher. For example, as I mentioned before, the smallpox vaccine has been shown to have some effects when combating monkeypox. But smallpox has been eradicated or declared eradicated in North America for quite some time. So we have a population who hasn't needed those vaccines for a couple generations at this point. Would our immunity be worse than other places where those smallpox vaccines were delivered more recently? That's possible. Now, moving on to the next question, and that is of transmission. Transmission of monkeypox happens when a person comes into contact with the virus, and here are the three sources typically, from an animal, a human, or materials contaminated with the virus. The virus is thought of as to enter the body through broken skin, your respiratory tract, or the mucous membrane, so your eyes, your nose, or your mouth. Animal-to-animal transmission may occur by biting, scratching, direct contact with body fluids or lesion material, even indirectly through contact with that same lesion material, such as contaminated bedding. Human-to-human transmission, on the other hand, is thought of to occur primarily through large respiratory droplets, and the CDC notes that these respiratory droplets generally cannot travel more than a few feet, so prolonged face-to-face contact is often required. You better keep your social distancing going. You've been trained on that for a couple years. It might come in handy right now, just to be extra cautious. Other human-to-human methods of transmission include direct contact with bodily fluids. I can imagine that not being good for people who are going out on dates. I think even kissing would be problematic. Or coming in contact with that lesion material. And even indirectly, through contact with contaminated clothing or linens. The linens is in particular quite interesting. If monkeypox became something of even a relatively minor concern, I can imagine the travel industry would be crippled again. Because now, people would just be afraid of going to hotels and Airbnbs and beds. Are they cleaned to the point where I can trust the linen? Now, although the answer might very well be yes and they have rigid standards for health and safety, especially after emerging from COVID-19, just the thought and the concern, that could do enough to cripple an already crippled industry. Especially when you tie in the fact that when you look at treatment, currently, as I mentioned, there is no proven safe treatment for the monkeypox virus. Now, for purposes of control, usually people would be administered a smallpox vaccine because, as we mentioned, there does seem to be some overlap between the two. And there are a couple other techniques that one can use, but they're not proven safe treatments. They might have secondary benefits, but it's not a cure. Now, these are basic facts about monkeypox. Let's extrapolate to our current situation. Should you be alarmed at this point in time? Well, health experts are alarmed, which is a good thing. They should be aware of the problem. They should be doing everything they can to contain it before it becomes a problem for everyone else. But things are not bad yet. And these health experts are reporting that our risk in Canada currently is low. Now, it doesn't mean that it's always going to be low. It doesn't mean that this can't turn bad. It doesn't mean that we can just continue to be oblivious to the threat, but it does mean take things in context. In Quebec, it's reported that there are about 24 suspected cases, and other provinces don't have numbers even close to that. So the transmission is not very high, and as we talked about, this is different than COVID-19. You'd have to be in a prolonged close-quarter situation for the risk to present itself if the assumption that the transmission is largely due to large respiratory droplets. If that turns out to be accurate, then this likely won't reach the same pandemic tier level as COVID, but that's still a possibility. At this point in time, what we're seeing is if we've learned anything from COVID-19. There was a point in its history where it did have a similar trajectory. People were not that worried about it. It was only the health experts who were concerned. The cases were very low. It was mostly contained, but then it exploded. And then it wasn't contained. And then it mutated. Then it became worse, and it basically crippled the global society that we've been developing for decades. Can monkeypox do the same thing? It could. That's why we have to rely on our health experts and scientists and personnel to do what they can to advise us, to do what they can to advise the government, to do what they can to establish a plan to ensure that doesn't happen. Now, if we take two back-to-back losses here, COVID had us down bad. If monkeypox is the same thing to us, I think we'll really have to evaluate how we approach disease as a global society. We probably didn't want to be tested again so quickly, but by their very nature, pandemics are unpredictable. If you could predict them, they likely wouldn't have happened in the first place. Right now, the Canadian government is doing their best. They have ordered some smallpox vaccines because we do know they do benefit those who are afflicted with monkeypox, and they're beginning to do some contact tracing. Again, the vaccine thing is interesting. As was made very evident with COVID-19, a country without domestic production is going to suffer. Imagine for a second that it turns out monkeypox is way worse than we thought, and we need those smallpox vaccines now. Well, where are they being produced? who's going to be ahead of us in the line? Not having domestic capabilities to handle your own business is a disaster. Now, we do have to give the Canadian government some credit because they have taken steps to remedy that lack of preparedness. They have made contracts and deals to get some domestic facilities up and running, and I just hope we won't need them too soon. Now with that, I will keep you up to date on the latest on the monkeypox front. And it now brings us to the end of our conversation for today. If you enjoyed the material, be sure to leave a review and share. They'll help us grow. And you can find me online at perryplatform.org and on social media at perryplatform. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you soon.